Okay, we are here after the Derby from Circle City, the event that we promoted. Susan ran there. She ran two vehicles on that night. One of them was this here Monte Carlo, and the other one was the big white van that we've been building for a while. So stay tuned on all the videos of that. If you haven't seen the actual event videos from this car, now's your chance before you catch all the aftermath highlights. Go check it out. There's a GoPro and there is the stands footage. We filmed it from above in the actual flag view nest. So really good view for both of those. It is Circle City Derby. They're only one this year for 2024. So how did this finish out for her? Well, it did very well, much better than we expected. Let me walk you around the car, give you a good highlight of it. As you see, the stick is still up on it, finishing first place with the Monte Carlo. Wasn't sure what to get out of this car. Back end, front end, mystery. You know, we don't see many aluminum subframe cars run. We didn't know what the back of this was going to do. We were very paranoid that it might plow. We put a lot of time into measuring and cutting and pre-bending the back to make it go right. Turned out really well on the back. We had, I think, probably 13 to 15 cars, something like that, in the front-wheel drive class. So not a bad count for that track at all. Gave some good room to drive, make some hits. And this thing, it ran really well. I don't know if it stalled at all, if much, if anything. It was doing so well until the very end when the rad let go. Mostly back-end driving early on, as you saw from the GoPro. You could hear the hits but not see them until later when she decided to turn around and use the front a bit more. So let's get a look at the back of this first, and we'll make our way to the front. Remember all that work we did in the time-lapse video. If you haven't seen it, now's a good time to remember to go check that out. You can see how we exactly measured it, where we cut our notches, pre-bending, everything on the trunk lid, all the work to make this roll how you see it now. Personally, I think it went just a tad too high. So you can see the speaker tray has come up right there in the air. I prefer that to be lower, almost like how we have the Fords over here. They're staying a little bit lower on us. And then, of course, the trunk lid came up with the speaker deck. So sitting in the car, it wasn't completely blocking your view, but it was getting up there to the point where you could not easily identify the shots you were making besides seeing the roof of a car. So from that point on, using the front was the only way to go if you were going to aim a shot. The rest was just making hits. It did not plow at all. It went at both notches, which you can see right there is one of them. It went up perfect right there. There's the rest of the frame wheel. It's kicking over, pulling inward. This one's a little bit different. It did bend up at the notches. Then later on, it appears a hard shot. Broke it loose from the frame rail. It is still attached nice and packed in there to the body. And the rest of the frame rail is packed right there, flattened in. Spare tire compartment's good. Subframe has not twisted or moved at all. I thought the rear sub on this would give us some problems because it's very rusty, very flaky. I was very much worried that was going to be an issue. Even the aluminum rear spindles have not shattered on this. Thought they might crack off. This side did take a good wheel shot. If you can tell, it is sitting a little crooked right there because the lower control arm is quite twisted on the shot. So this one's starting to move. That one, the lower control arm is still very straight on that wheel. It's just getting caught in the metal. So to be honest, I think it was a good thing this did end up blocking her view a tiny bit, and she ended up using the front when she did, because a little bit longer and I fear this wheel could have kicked sideways and the other one may have locked up. It would have reduced the mobility of this car a lot by the end of the Derby. Looking in the back seat, we can see the floor and the seams have not moved on it, so that's a good sign. Typically, the next thing you'll see on these W-bodies is right here on this rear strut tower. It starts blowing through the seams. You can see down there in the back trunk, we are tight up against the back of the spare tire compartment. Strut towers are just now starting to block and make a nice ramming package. So the back of this is doing really good. Honestly, if we get that push down, the back of this would easily go another Derby. So that's a good sign. Working our way around the car. Front is weird. It's going to be the best scenario for this. Both fenders, and we're going to show you here when we get the hood off, both fenders are basically barely holding on. We have already cut the nine wire, so that didn't fall off in the derby. We cut the nine wire to take the hood off of this to look down in it right before this so we get an idea of what's going on. Yeah, crazy to see these fenders rip loose like this. Not typical for the older style W bodies. Maybe this is a Monte Carlo thing. Maybe this is the newer gen style. I don't know. But it has, the bolts are all still there. It just pretty much sucked every single one of them right out through the mounting holes. So the only thing holding this fender on is the bolts way at the rocker. And I think there's one bolt right under there, barely holding, that's twisted. So, and that whole fender would have came off. You can actually tell, go back and watch the GoPro again if you haven't, towards the end there, because this fender's broke loose and this fender has broke loose. See how much this one's flopping as well, even down there. Has basically got nothing on it. When the front of this takes some hits, or it makes hits, the hood and the fenders are shaking like jello because they're just kind of floating on this car at this point. It's really crazy. So yeah, that did good. Working our way around. Now let's talk about the front bumper and subframe. This was a big stressing point on this car that we were worried about. So remember, we ran this chrome bumper. This is a hollow chrome bumper. It's not your 80s Ford bumpers or anything like that. It's just a shell. So we knew, obviously, you couldn't go forwards the entire derby with something like this. But to be honest, I'm really happy with how it did. I thought this thing would flatten completely flat. It tried to. It started to. You can tell right here, it's puckering out on the bottoms. And it's definitely twisted all through here. But it was a pretty thick chrome bumper, just being a shell. And it held its own. So I'm really surprised on that. It did what we wanted. It cushioned some of the damage to the frame to buy us time. Now, this frame rail has not pushed in like the driver's side. This side I'll show you first. You can see here, it's starting to kick right there and right there. And the aluminum has not moved at all on this side. And then once you get inside of it, you can see right about in here where it wants to come up, which is a good thing. So honestly, I think the passenger side is bending how we want it to bend. It's going to bring that subframe and that upper rail all as one straight up in the air. The driver's side is a completely different story. Very, very similar, I mean almost identical to how the Buick Century that we ran earlier this year collapsed. You'll notice bumper is still high and out. As you follow it, it goes deeper and deeper underneath the hood. That's because it's all the way underneath the core support. It has collapsed straight in. Instead of nosing up, it pushed in. And when it did that, it pushed this way. There's your crush box point where the bolts are. That is twisted sideways, just like the other side's starting to do. Then it pushed your upper rail as it accordioned inward. It blew that kind of sideways. And then the aluminum subframe is actually dropping down. So some of these cars, you'll see this aluminum arm pivot upwards that direction and lift up, and it'll snap it off right there at the ear. This one instead, when this guy pushed in, this whole thing is pushing the corner of this subframe straight down. It's very bizarre because I know the Buick Centuries will do this. Remember, we saw that happen with Susan. She lost steering when that pushes down. What happens is this entire sub will get lower and lower. Eventually, it will disconnect the steering shaft underneath there, or it will pull the axles out of the transmission cups because it's too low to keep them connected. So I can show you, if it's hard to tell on camera, you can look at the front right on, and you can see the height difference. So let me get you down low, see if you guys can see it. There you go. So you see the height right here on that one, and you follow it over, and the height on that one is several inches lower on that corner. So this whole thing is tipping downwards on this end. So very strange to see that. Also, the biggest issue that we have, and I still have not found the culprit, hopefully we're going to dig into that later today, towards the very end of this, when this bumper nosed up, she was hitting the final three cars, and the hits were coming under this bumper for some of those shots. As you can tell by the bottom of this AC condenser, and the radiator has mushed the bottom of that all the way up in there. So when it did that, somewhere in there we have got a massive transmission leak. I don't know if it's the looped lines that are right back in there. I don't know if it's the actual transmission housing has got a crack in there or what. But when you start this car, even when the derby was over, there's a puddle on the track, and driving it back on the trailer, even driving it here into the shop, it still runs and moves. But it is pouring transmission fluid like crazy right out of this corner as soon as it turns on. So it's got to be about empty at this point between us moving it on and off the trailer and getting it back in here. We will dig into that next and see if we can figure out what went wrong. If I had to guess, I'm thinking maybe something just cut a rubber line, something like that. It'd be terrible, worst case scenario, if we have a transmission issue that is opened up on this. So let's go ahead and pull the hood off and let's look down in there and see what's happening underneath this car. All right, so hood's off, sitting right there. Now you can really see just how bad this is. That bumper has completely crushed inwards and underneath this entire core support. Here's the edge of your core support. The bumper is deep, deep behind there. And you can truly see how much of that frame has crushed in on top of itself down here and twisted all up along there. Again, super, super similar to that Buick Century. Not a good sign when we're seeing this. That's bad. I don't want it to go that way. But looking at, on the passenger side, it has not collapsed up in here. Instead, it's kicking right here by the strut tower right there, which is good. Maybe it'll actually bend upwards as one long arm and not collapse inwards. That would be good if this side does that. Motor is sitting a little bit sideways. You can see the upper motor mounts have shifted. Maybe there's a broken motor mount underneath. I'm not sure. We'll get into that. You can see much better now. These fenders have got nothing left holding them on. Even this side over here is completely gone. Looking down in here, the fan has crushed into the front of the engine, locked up the fan blades, so I'm sure it's popped the fuse for that. That fan's done. The radiator, surprisingly, the sidewalls of the radiator are good, the plastic. So it has lost coolant because it was steaming and blowing out like crazy by the end of the show. I'm going to guess it's got to be damaged somewhere right under there where it's curled under. Probably blew the bottom fins out. That is also the general vicinity where the loop kit is, and I just can't get eyes on it to see the loops. So yeah, somewhere down in there is where the loop kit has taken one heck of a hit, and we're gonna know better because we're gonna undo these motor mounts, we're gonna get the radiator and all that uncut loose fan, and we're gonna lift all that stuff out, open the whole front of this and see what kind of damage we have going on to decide what the fate of this car will be next. And then I also have to decide if it's worth fixing this rail on this side or getting it back up to run again. Otherwise, rest of it is in really good shape. It's just this corner is the problem on the driver's side. That's the debate on where to go from here. Up here is great. Wiring is great. Again, this is all factory wiring, factory shifter, all that's still there. We just spray foamed and tied down your fuse box, stuff up there. Belt has survived. You can see down there that cup and CV axle is throwing grease out of it, so it's been coming open and closed on the boot covering. That's not a good sign. That means you definitely got a motor mount or the engine, something's moving to cause that to come apart right there on that boot. So I'll probably put a jack under it once we get these mounts broke loose, and I will lift up the floor jack under the engine, and we're going to see if this motor will lift up and down off of one of these mounts somewhere and see what's broke on it, try to diagnose it from there as well. Overall, pretty happy with this car. It was a good test run. We've been wanting to run a Monte Carlo for a while. We've been wanting to run the aluminum subframe for a while. This is nice. Keep in mind, we do have two of the newer style Impalas way out there in the collection. They are like 2009s, 2012s, that style of Impala, a little bit newer than this. Different motor, but exact same subframes. So we wanted to get a good feel for them with this car. So as we build more in the future, we'll try to figure out what we can do different on the front of these. So there you have it. Pretty awesome. Susan keeping her streak, finishing first place in the front-wheel drive derby. And stay tuned, we are going to have updates coming of the big van, the aftermath, and all the results from that too in another video.